may be seated. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore. And I hold the keys of hell and death, and because I live, you shall live also. Friends and family, we have gathered here today to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate the beautiful life of Stan Chase. We come together in our grief, acknowledging our human loss. May God grant us grace that in pain we may find comfort, in sorrow, hope, and in death, resurrection. Would you pray with me? Gracious God, we come before you now, and we thank you for life, and we thank you for life everlasting. We ask that you would be merciful to us and give us your comfort as we go forward to praise your name and to celebrate Stan's beautiful life. We ask all this in Jesus' name, amen. So I'm going to ask those forward who will be helping and singing How Great Thou Art to come forward. And congregation, I would ask you to stand as we sing this beautiful song.
Thank you.
times of grief and sorrow, when we know not where to go, we go to Scripture. So would you join with me together for the 23rd Psalm? The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Our New Testament lesson comes to us from John chapter 14. Hear this word. Don't be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. My Father's house has room to spare. If that weren't the case, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And when I go to prepare a place for you, I will return and take you to be with me, so that where I am, you will be too. You know the way to the place that I'm going. I won't leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Soon the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, and because I live, you will also live. I have spoken these things to you while I am with you. The companion, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and will remind you of everything I told you. My peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I give to you not as the world gives. So don't be troubled or afraid. This is the word of the Lord. Amen. And now I would invite you to listen, even sing along if you would like, to this hymn, Sweet Hour of Prayer.
On him my every care. Sweet hour of prayer. Sweet hour of prayer.
Earl Stanley. Stan Chase, 69, of Spring Branch, Texas, passed away on December 21st, 2022. Stan is survived by his wife of 52 years, Irene, his children, Jim and wife, Janet, and John and wife, Carrie, four grandchildren, Christopher, Andrew, Austin, and Amber, and sister, Jean. He was preceded in death by his parents, David and Edna, and his brother, Russell. Stan was born in Petersburg, Virginia, and grew up outside of Chicago, Illinois, where he attended Illinois Benedictine College and then Caltech in Pasadena, California. Stan joined the U.S. Air Force in 1979, embarking upon a 30-year career serving his country as a B-52 radar navigator and crew member, on to various command assignments that took him from California, North Dakota, Alabama, Maine, Nebraska, Colorado, Louisiana, and finally here to Texas, achieving the rank of full colonel. In 2009, having completed his final assignment as vice commander of the Air Force Recruiting Service at Randolph Air Force Base, Stan retired to the Hill Country north of San Antonio. Stan was an active member here at North Shore United Methodist Church in Canyon Lake and a dedicated employee at Ace Hardware in Wimberley, Texas. As is true of all of us, Stan's life was about far more than what is reflected in his career. One of Stan's favorite pastimes was singing, whether as part of the church choir or when he could find one, a local barbershop quartet association. Indeed, he passed down the love of the barbershop quartet to his son John and his grandson Austin, instilling the love of performing into the next generation. Stan loved a good story, and he loved telling a good story. But in telling one, one had to be perfectly clear. The Chase family has fully embraced the time-honored axiom introduced into our lexicon by Mark Twain, never let the truth get in the way of a good story. Stan didn't necessarily tell tall tales or whoppers, but you could be sure he would make use of the occasional embellishment to maximize his audience's enjoyment and to enhance the tale of its telling. Stan was both a leader and a servant and a mentor to many throughout his life, to his family, to his friends, to those in whom he worked in service to our country and to many, many others. Even in retirement, when all he aspired to do was to take his love of tools and projects into a simple job at a hardware store, his care for the customer and serving them well drew upon his rich experience. To his ace co-workers, he remained with deepest respect, the colonel. Finally, Stan adored his family. From his unending and undying love for his wife, Irene, to his wholehearted devotion to his sister, Jean, and to the tremendous joy and pride in each of his children and grandchildren, when it came to his love of family, few things could move him more deeply or more profoundly. And yet today, we know and trust that Stan is singing a new song in the presence of the Almighty, the Savior, singing a song with joy that knows no bound and no end. I want to read to you a poem, that was written by his niece, Tanya. It's entitled, You Will Be Missed. Dearest Uncle Stan, you have held a special place in my heart since I can remember. I miss you so terribly much. I still remember the thrill of sneaking off while the rest of our family slept in tents to have pancakes in a warm restaurant. And the looks on their faces when we returned to find them eating cold cereal and Pop-Tarts. I have loved you every day of my life, but I have felt a special connection with you since that day. you will be missed. I remember fondly all the Christmases our families were together. I was always the one chosen to wake you up so we could do presents. I was always elected because the kids knew you wouldn't be mad at me. That is but one of the memories I will carry with me, along with my memory of the man that you were. You will be missed. Since I was little, I always knew that if anything were to happen to my parents, you and Aunt Irene would step in. And that gave me some peace and comfort and kept me anchored throughout the years. You will be missed. Your ability to tell a story and to command a room with your presence was matched by few. You will be missed. I always knew, although you seemed tough, you had a heart of gold and were a big softy when it counted. You played hide and seek with my kids and pretended to be a zombie. And the games were the talk of our house for many years. We loved you so very much, and this world is a little less bright without you in it. You will be missed. Yes, you will be missed, but you will live on in our memories and our stories and in the way we live our lives. With all my love, Tanya. Thank you, Tanya, for sharing that. As I come to this time when I want to talk to you about Stan, you know, we come to this time and we talk about our faith and what it means to really understand resurrected life, to what it really means to understand how when somebody touches our lives and that spills over into our lives. And that's why our hearts are and our eyes are overflowing right now, because we had so many wonderful memories. You know, when I read this text, and when I read his obituary, the line that really grabbed me was this last line that said, "And yet today we know and trust that Stan is singing a new song in the presence of the Almighty, the Savior, singing with joy that knows no bounds and no ends." Indeed, Stan is singing a new song. But I want you to just take a moment, just in the silence here, because Stan, among many things, was a singer. And one thing that a singer would know is that the pause, the silence, right, is just as important as all the musical notes. And right here, right now, in this time that we are in the silence, there's a pause in our lives as we have to recalculate ourselves in the world without Stan present with us. You know, the Bible talks about singing a new song. I remember standing right here in this room and after coming off a mission trip and asking the members to what kind of new song was in their heart. Many of the Psalms and Isaiah 40 talk about a new song, because after having an experience of God, after having been changed in some way or having an experience, you are new and you sing a new song. That pause that we're experiencing today, it's mainly because there is still this melody that is flowing in our lives because of Stan. And so when those days and weeks come when you feel that pain that will wash over you, I want you to remember that in that pause, how much of Stan's song, the chords of his life, the melody of his life has affected your life, has made you who you are today. Somebody who's been a companion with you in church, who's served alongside of you, you've witnessed singing here in this church, who's been your father and your grandfather, your husband, your friend. Your life has a new song because of Stan. But make no mistake about it, that Stan, even though we would all love for him to be here, that Stan is singing a new song, and we're grateful for that, that our Lord and Savior has taken Stan to himself, So Stan is not gone. Stan is still singing. His song will never end. And one day our chorus will meet up with his. But until then, remember how Stan's life played in your own heart, how his presence made you more fully who you are today. Remember how mischievous he was. Remember how he was such a tough man. He was a man of respect, and he was a man of dignity. He was a man of justice. And as tough as he was, and as hard as he battled through many illnesses, he was such a softy, prone to tears, one of my male criers here at this church. And I love that about him. Love that about him. Stan was one of those people that really gave fullness to the life of this church. To see you all singing with him, singing this new song with him on this side of heaven. You know, there's a story that says when somebody leaves this life, there's a group of people on the shore waving goodbye, and there's also a group of people on the other shore welcoming them home. You know, and sometimes healing, and this is true of Stan, is not going to happen on this side of life. But fullness and healing has happened for Stan, and for that we're grateful. Let's pray. Gracious God, it's the hardest thing to lose a friend and to lose a loved one. Well, Stan was particularly special. But we are grateful for his song. We are grateful for the joy that he brought our lives. We're grateful for the rivers that ran so deeply within his soul. We're so grateful for his humor, for his wit, for his voice. And in those days when we feel like we are hurting, we will pause in the silence and know that that song continues to play. And we will rejoice that we will be singing a song with Stan one day with you. In Jesus' name, amen. Would you please rise as you are able? As we say the Apostles' Creed together, I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. On the third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated. And would you listen to this special music? Goodbye, world. Goodbye.
I told all my troubles goodbye,
goodbye,
say goodbye to each tear and each sigh,
every sign
for this world where I roam cannot be my home,
so I'm bound for a land up in the sky,
cause I walk and I talk with my
Lord,
and I feast every day on his word,
saying
heaven is near and I can stay here,
so it's goodbye world, goodbye.
When I'm gone,
cause I won't have to leave here alone.
That morning when I hear that last
trumpet sound,
and all my feet won't stay on the ground.
I'm gonna
rise with a shout, gonna fly.
I'm gonna
ride with my Lord through the sky.
I'm saying heaven is near,
you know, and I can stay here.
So it's
goodbye, world, goodbye.
Well, there won't be no blues anymore.
Not as I step across that
shore.
And I'll never pine, for I leave behind
all my heartaches and
guarantees forevermore, forevermore, another day,
maybe
or two,
then
then we'd fight
to tomorrow. I'll rise, I don't fly. Heaven is near, and I can see him.
So it's goodbye, world, goodbye.
Now don't you weep for me when I'm gone, 'cause I won't have to leave you alone.
That last trumpet sound. Well, my feet won't stay on the ground. I'm gonna rise with a shout, gonna fly. I'll ride with my Lord through the sky.
Saying
heaven is near,
you know,
and I can't stay here.
So it's
goodbye, world, goodbye. I'll rise with a shout,
gonna fly.
I'm gonna ride with my Lord through the sky.
Near,
and I can't stay here. Goodbye, world. Goodbye, world.
Goodbye.
It's goodbye, world.
Amazing. Stan would have loved that. Stan does love that. I want you to join me with the confidence of the children of God with the Lord's Prayer. Together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom. Amen. Would you pray with me? Gracious God, we are so thankful for Stan. But what we know is that before he was ours, he is yours. And so reluctantly, we have given him back to you. And we know he is more fully himself than he has ever been here on earth. But Father, we ask that you continue to be around this family and his friends and loved one in the days and weeks where they're particularly in grief, that they would draw ever more closer to one another, that they would find their strength in you. And that you would continue to bless us to sing beautiful songs together until we all meet together in your heavenly kingdom and sing this new song with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now I would invite you to share some food, although I said that we needed to have double-stuffed Oreos out there because it was one of Stan's favorites. But would you go with this blessing? Would you rise, please? May you go from this place and may you remember those words that Jesus said in John 14, that my peace I give you, my peace I leave you, that we will not be discouraged or afraid, for we know that we go from life to new life, and that Stan is new, and that is our history and our trajectory as well. We thank you, Father, for this hour, for this time to celebrate this beautiful life and to give you thanks for all life. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm going to ask you to allow the family to go first, and then we will exit.